What's up, Zombie Slayers? This is KG4E, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. This is episode 53, and I'm going to do something I don't normally do, or I haven't done much on this series, if ever. I'm actually going to record through the night. Actually, I have recorded through the night before, but I don't do it often. But we're going to record through the night, and I'm going to be doing some building so it won't be boring. And first things first, I need to figure out what I want the flooring to be in this game down here. And I think my hallway is going to be flagstone. Flagstone floor. If I can get over there without... Can I hit that? Ooh, nice. Alright, so that's going to be flagstone floor. All the way down. And I think that's going to look pretty sweet. Alright, so flagstone floor for the hallway. That's a done deal. And I need something solid for in here, but I can't use brick or brick paver. I mean, I guess I could use the brick paver. And actually might look pretty good, the brick paver, now that I think about it. Because it'll match what the forges are on, but it'll be connected to the floor. So that might actually look good. What do you think, brick paver? We've got a lot of them left. It'd be a shame to let them go to waste. Let's see what these will look like. First thing we can do is come right here. And let's just mine out a bunch of areas. And brick paver for the floor. Honestly, I kind of like it. I kind of like it for the floor. I wasn't sure if I wanted to use it because I already used it in the room. But I don't know, I kind of think it ties the room together nicely. By the way, this is going to be my buddy Scott's, who watches my videos. This is going to be his favorite video because he always likes it when I make my places look nice. He always tells me this is the most important part of a zombie apocalypse, and I agree. Alright, put that down there. Yes, that actually looks really, really good. I didn't think it would look that good, but it does. It's almost like since the brick paver is made out of the same stuff as the floor, it's just like the floor is being raised here. So, yes, I do like that. Alright, so what do we want the doorway to be? The door's got to be brick. Because it's the same thing as the walls. You're going to come over here. I'm going to go ahead and make some more flagstone. 26. Yeah, let's make 26. We're going to need it. And I need something to drink. I have not been paying attention to my goldenrod. Actually, last night, I ran out to the farm really quick before nighttime, after I ended the video. And I didn't plant any goldenrod. So I picked some goldenrod on the way back, and I got 15 seeds. So we're going to go attend to the farm as soon as it's daytime out. All right, so what do I need? I need more of this. Okay. All right, so you can go up here. And let's grab ourselves a pickaxe. Yeah, I was like, you know what? Let me just show some of the... I want to be building down here, and I'm not going to be building without you guys seeing it. Unless it's boring, but I don't think this is boring. This is decision-making. This is building, you know, this is how I... You know, this is how I make my decisions. Alright, so there we go. Looking good. What I really want to do is this room. I want to get the goddamn storage room done so I could start really organizing my chests. Alright, so that is good. Yep, that looks good. And we are going to put... Do we want to put vault doors down here? Now, here's the thing. Putting vault doors down here kind of sucks. Because, first of all, it uses a lot of material. Second of all, it takes a while to open. I don't think we need vault doors. No. Because vault doors, you come down here and then you're waiting an hour for the damn thing to open. And, you know, if it, Let me make some forged iron. Oops, I was making brass in here and I forgot. There we go. Anyway, yeah, and then you come down here and you gotta wait for your the door to open. And then you're like, well, the door takes so long to open, I don't think I wanna close it. But if you're not gonna close it, what the hell do you have a door there for? So I'm just gonna use regular doors down here. Alright. Hard metal door. Okay, so now we got that all done. Now we need to figure out what we're gonna do with the ceiling. Do we need to do anything with the ceiling? I usually don't do anything with the ceiling. And I'm kind of running out of blocks. Well, there's one more block I can do called Adobe. and there's peach, there's white, there's all kinds of stuff. I'm thinking about using white. Here it is. Okay, we need crushed sand for that. And some small stones, which I don't think I have any. I'm cooking them on. Alright, turn you off. And turn you back on. Alright, so we got Adobe Peach. Let's make a couple of those. Let's make make two of those. And Adobe White, we'll make two of those. And we'll put those down and see what they look like. As the ceiling. Now the ceiling's going to be the same no matter what room I'm in. The flooring is going to be different. This floor is going to be in here, but the storage room floor is going to be something different. Actually, I kind of wanted the storage room floor to be Adobe now that I think about it. What could I do with the ceiling though? You know, I'm kind of running out of stuff here. You got two kinds of Adobes. I don't think I'm going to like the peach. Maybe I will. I don't know. Let's see. Oh, peach. Yeah, it's kind of got an orange look to it. I don't think there's anything else I can make in here that'll be a good block for the ceiling. I really don't need to do the ceiling. I could just leave it stone. Let's just leave the ceiling stone for the time being. I'll just leave that up there. It ain't hurting nobody. Alright, so we're gonna need more brick. I think. Well, we got a lot of brick right there. Let's have a lot of forged iron. It's very good. There's a lot of stuff in here. Alright, so this one's... Let's just put that right there. And we left a lot of our iron up top, so we're not going to be cooking any more iron into that. We'll just cook the that stuff. Alright, so let's go ahead and take the brick and let's start working on our storage room, because this is kind of a big deal. Is this all the brick I have? Wow. Well, okay. Alright, so this is a storage room. Now, I want the storage room to be... Do I want the storage room to look just like this, or a little different, or very different? I don't know how I want the storage room to look. Alright, I've got an idea the way I want my storage room to work. By the way, I did make a gun safe. I'm going to definitely use gun safes in the storage room. But for now, let's just go ahead and take some of these brick thingies. Alright, so this goes right like that. That's one past the window. That's going to be the window. Alright, so this goes like this. Right? Right. Sure, why not? Alright, so that goes past the window, down into, and then deeper. And then behind it is more brick. Alright, so that goes deeper, so we need to cut this out. I just want to make sure I do this room exactly the way I did the other room. Well, it's going to have little variants to it, but it's going to be almost the same. There, there, there. Okay. So this comes back. You can see why I was digging out this room, because I mean, a lot of room in here. I don't have any room for that stone, do I? Or most of it. Let's drop some of the stuff off. That, anything else? We could drop off the Adobe stuff. And the bullets. And we could put the door down. Okay, there we go. Boom. Yeah. I love it. I love it. There's absolutely no reason to close all my doors, but I will anyway, because it's awesome. I mean, what's the point of having doors if you're not going to close them? Alright. Okay. So that should be just like the other side. And it is. Okay. So that goes over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7. We'll go 7 for now. It's going to go over more than 7, but for now we'll just go over 7. And then I have to plan out what storage boxes are going to go where. That should be fun. By the way, you can hear the screamers up top. I'm hoping they're dying on the spikes. Okay, it is morning. I'm going to show you what I've done so far. The floor is going to be wood. And for the rest of the build, you're just going to have to wait and see. I have an idea what I'm going to do, but I just don't have it finalized yet in my brain. Sounds like there's a screamer up there, so let's get up there and take care of some business. All right, wait. Shh. Let's listen. Where are you, sneaky bastard? She should be out there because that's where the forge is. Prefer not to deal with a horde if I could avoid it. I don't know how she would have avoided all that barbed wire, though. The hell is she? She might be dead. I haven't heard her in a while. I don't see or hear her, so... Oh, there's a dog, though. Can't have that. Okay. Oh, there she is. Alright. I'll deal with you myself. Okay. Oh. It's pretty badass defense, guys. I'm not gonna lie. This defense is just bruising. I just love it. I love it. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? Alright, let's see. Oh boy, hold on. Alright. Let's see what we got up here, because I don't know if I left anything up here. I did not. So, you know what we forgot? We forgot that there's a damn dog on our ass. We actually forgot. We gotta go back down and get forge shine and make barbed wire. Unless I left some up here, I'm kinda curious. After she screams the first time, you've got 20 seconds before she screams again, so. Alright, no barbed wire or anything up here. Let me go back and get some. Alright, guys, we got no barbed wire here, and I do have it crafting, but it's going to take a while. So why don't we go take care of the farm thing? It'll also give the area a chance to cool down so I can come back without having to worry about screamers and heat hordes and stuff. Man, this, I know I'm gonna mention the barbed wire quite a bit, but I'm sorry, I can't help it. It's the best. Just love it. It just stops everything. I get screamer hordes. They can't really even do much, man. They just get caught on barbed wire. Can't move until they're dead. All right. Come back. Oh, I will. I think I'm in the wrong spot anyway. Nope, I am not in the wrong spot. See you later, Fido. Punk ass freaking mutt. I hate you! Alright, so let's check this place. Oh, my goodness, seriously? Really? Unbelievable. As I run headfirst into a tree. Okay. Ah, we got a dog. Screw this freaking dog. I've had enough dogs for one lifetime. I don't want to fight anything near my bike. What the hell? Sons of bitches. Down you go. Down you go. Crotch shot. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead again. You're double dead. You're dead too. And you're gone. Okay. Apparently I haven't been here in a while. The zombies started respawning. I knew you can clear an area out for you new players. Supposedly when you kill all the zombies in an area, it's supposed to stay clear for 5 days. So. All right. There's the hoe. We could probably make this farm a little bigger too. Where did that? There it is. All right, let's work on this for a little bit. First of all, let's pick everything that's here. Now, a lot of you new players who maybe haven't been here before might be asking me how come I'm not picking that corn. I just feel like it's overpowered. It's so much freaking corn. Like, I'd rather grow my own crops. Okay. Potatoes, taters. Got some taters. Alright. Goldenrod. We need to get this stuff pumping. I completely lost track of the goldenrod. I never replanted it. That was such a mistake. Alright. So what do we want to replant? Well, we definitely want to replant the cotton. Actually, I want to turn that all into cotton seeds. Stop that. Barbed wire, start that back up again. I probably won't replant the potatoes. Well, maybe I should. I do need potatoes for that meat stew. It's really good. Problem is, the problem with the meat stew is it smells, and when I'm eating it underground, it causes issues. I'm not gonna do anything with the blueberries. I'm just gonna actually leave them here, because. Honestly, there's nothing really good to make food with blueberries. You make a blueberry pie, but you need eggs, and I can't depend on the fact that I'm going to get eggs. Did I not replant corn either? Wow, I never replanted the freaking corn. I'm such an idiot. No, I'm going to plant this corn now. Alright. Anyway, yeah, blueberry, you can't depend on getting eggs. You always run out of eggs, so blueberry pie is not really a thing you're going to have a lot of, and, you know, it's going to be reliable for you or anything. So the only thing blueberry is really good for is some herbal antibiotics. I never got those, did I? You know, I should probably go get those. I'll do it after the 49-day horde. There's these things you get. I don't think I have one, actually. Oh, here it is. Treasure maps. You can get treasure maps, and they usually have whenever you find a treasure map, they usually always have, inside of them, a recipe for some herbal antibiotics. You need blueberries for that. That's really the only reason I ever planted the blueberries. The only thing I care about is cotton, goldenrod, and corn, and to a lesser extent, potatoes. Here's the problem, though. I want to start living off of cornbread because cornbread does not smell. It's not as good as the meat stew, but you know I can carry it around with me. I don't have to worry about eating it underground without pissing off any screamers that might be up top. So that means we probably should plant some more corn. I hate the friggin' dogs, in case you couldn't tell. Yep, I'm on the wrong side. It is gonna be a little bit hard to get around these buildings with those barbed wire in the middle, but, you know, small price to pay for security. Hello, dog. Oh, boo. I'm gonna get him this time. I'm gonna get you, mutt. Boom! That's what you get. Damn, where'd he go? Man, I really destroyed him. Like, I destroyed him. He's gone. He's not... He's no longer of this planet. Wow. See? That's what happens. Alright, so this side is done. We need to concentrate on this side. Alright, so this is gonna be a second side. So this one's not gonna have three. So because of the way I did this, this is not going to have the same amount. Nah, yeah, it is. Who cares? It's all good. Yeah, we're good. Let's go. I should not have brought the hoe with me, by the way. I'm supposed to leave that on the damn farm. Okay. Start breaking stuff out, people. Oh, this is the part I was supposed to do off camera, wasn't it? Yeah, let's do that off camera. To hell with it. I'm not doing that shit now. Forget that. I got time for that. Actually, before we do anything, set up a little bit of a... See, this is something I want to change too. Oh, I can't do it now. Alright, so you see this pole right here? I lined this pole up with that pole because I thought that would be cool, but I wanted this pole right here to line up with the edge of the barbed wire. It doesn't ever make sense for barbed wire to have an edge without going to a pole. That's the whole point of these poles. So this pole needs to get moved over here, and the same thing with that one. I will do that eventually. Not going to do it right now, but I will do it eventually. Just something I'm letting you know I'm thinking about. This,
and this.
There. That's better. Alright, let's go to our drop-off chest. We need to grab some metal. And take the stone, because I want to take that downstairs. And that's good. Alright, let's get to work. Man, I do not have a lot of log spikes left. I don't have a lot of wood left. It's a problem. Spikes. I'm not gonna make any more spikes. We'll just put down the ones we got now. And, I think today, in this game day, after the video, before I record next, I will go find a bunch of trees to cut down. There's actually a bunch of ones that I planted by my farm. I know you saw them, so those are the ones I'm gonna use. Alright, I don't know how far this needs to come. Probably doesn't need to go any farther than that one. Okay, so like right there. And that's it for this set of spikes. So that is two full rows of spikes, not including any spikes that are against the building. The only variance in any of the design is that right here, anywhere where the spikes would have been on the curb, I moved them out into the street. So technically these spikes are way farther away than those spikes than I wanted them to be, but that's okay. I don't know if that makes any sense to you. Here, let me spell this out for you. Okay. I wanted all my spikes to be four blocks away from each other. So 1, 2, 3, 4, just like that. But because these would have come out 1, 2, 3, 4, they would have come out here, which is a spot I don't like them. I moved them out to a spot where I did like them. So in other words, in an ideal situation, the spikes have four blocks in between. If it doesn't work out, it has 4, 5, 6, 7 blocks in between or whatever. 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. Which I'm okay with. And it has the same level defense. The only difference is the space in between the spikes. Which, honestly, really doesn't matter. At all. Because I have enough room out here for another row of spikes. Easily. At that point, I'm going to start moving up on the curbs on the other side of the street. And that's not ideal. So, I will probably only do one more set of row spikes, probably. Unless I lose my mind, which is... very possible. Alright, so you guys go right here. right. All right, guys, I'm going to call this video right now because I'm going to take out some time before I have to go to bed tonight to pickaxe some of these curbs. And we should be good to go to finish this off next time I record, which will probably be day 49. So that's going to be it for episode 53, and I'll see you next time for episode 54. Until then, take it easy.